crisis. It should be that giving private entities public missions is fundamentally flawed. The most glaring case was Fannie and Freddie, who, as Alan Greenspan put it last week, quote, paid whatever price was necessary to reach affordable housing goals, which were so important to their allies in Congress. This led to the GSEs taking on well over $1 trillion in junk loans, which then led to the GSEs' failure and the collapse in the housing market. No one has said that CRA was the primary cause of the housing crisis. What economists have argued is that CRA was a contributor to this problem. CRA falls in the same category as Fannie and Freddie, mandating that private institutions offer loans they otherwise would not offer contributed to the erosion of credit standards throughout the market. You can't have a situation where we in Congress muscle down 20% down payment rates to get them down to 3% or 0%, by the way, and not think that is going to have an impact. And along those same lines, CRA also acted as a bargaining tool for activist organizations. The CRA requirement that banks have good CRA records for regulatory approval of a merger or acquisition gave groups like Acorn ammunition to shake down financial institutions, and that's what they were doing, to shake down financial institutions for either direct contributions or affordable housing commitments. According to the 2007 annual report of the National Community Reinvestment Coalition, the four largest U.S. banks, Citi, B of A, Wells Fargo, JPMC, or their predecessors, had made commitments under the CRA to make more than $4.5 trillion in CRA-type loans between 1993 and 2007. Countrywide Financial, through a HUD program, created their own affordable housing goals and committed to make $1 trillion in loans to low- and middle-income borrowers. While a number of those loans went to creditworthy borrowers, many did not. By 2008, these programs resulted in over 2 million high-risk loans. With respect to all loans made under CRA, by some estimates, half were made to borrowers who made down payments of 5% or less or had below prime credit scores, both characteristics that indicated a high credit risk. Instead of expanding this unsound law, I believe it should be significantly scaled back or abolished altogether. If the goal is to ensure lending practices are not based on race or where an individual lived, many experts agree that enforcing the existing fair lending and antitrust laws would get us there if they were enforced. I look forward to hearing from our witnesses today, and I yield back.